Good morning, children. Welcome back to our maths class. So, children, in our today's class, we are going to continue workbook. Okay, from chapter 9, that is fractions 2. Clear? As already we have completed first concept, that is fraction of a number from workbook. Now, in our today's class, we are going to do another topic which we have already learned: conversion of fractions. That is concept 9.2. Got it, children? We are going to discuss questions based on conversion of fractions. Clear? So, children, as I have already explained it to you, fraction of a number, then conversion of fractions. How to convert fractions? That means you know the types of fractions are what? Proper fraction, improper fraction, mixed fraction. I have explained it to you how to convert improper fraction to mixed fraction, mixed fraction to improper fraction. Yes? So, before we move on to workbook questions, let's do a quick recap based on conversion of fractions. Alright, so here I have written two questions. Clear? Convert 4 1 by 6 into improper fractions. So tell me, children, how you are going to convert, what type of fraction this one? This is a mixed fraction. Yes, mixed fractions are what? Mixed fractions are what, children? Mixed fractions are mixed fractions having whole number and a proper fraction. Yes or no? So this is a mixed fraction. What you have to do? You have to convert it into improper fraction. So how you are going to convert? Yes, children, tell me, as already we have learned. Yeah. So let's see. Let's do one more time this revision. To convert mixed fraction into improper fraction, what do you have to do? Yes, whole number into denominator. Whole number is 4. 4 into 6 plus numerator by denominator. This is A. Okay. 4 into 6, 24 plus 1 by 6 is 25 by 6. So required improper fraction is how much? 25 by 6. Got it? So we have converted 4 1 by 6, that is mixed fraction, into improper fraction. We got how much? 25 by 6. Yeah, next number B, 37 by 6. 37 by 6 is a what type of fraction? Improper fraction. Yes or no? Yes, because in improper fraction, numerators are greater than their denominators. Now what you have to do here? Yes, you have to convert into what fraction? Mixed fraction. Yes, so how you are going to convert, children? How you are going to convert improper fraction into mixed fraction? Yes, by doing division. Okay, by doing division, we have to convert improper fraction into mixed fraction. So number B, 37 you divided by 6. 6 into 6 equal to 36. So 7 minus 6, 1. We did division, then what we have to do? Our remainder will be numerator. Question will be whole number. And divisor will be the denominator. So required mixed fraction is 6, 1 by 6. When we convert improper fraction 37 by 6 into mixed fraction, we get 6, 1 by 6. Yes? So based on this conversion, mixed fraction to improper fraction, improper fraction to mixed fraction, now we are going to do the workbook based question. Alright, topic is what? Conversion of fractions. Concept 9.2. Got it, children? What problems then? How to convert multiple choice questions? On the topic conversion of fractions, we are going to discuss. Yeah, so let's start workbook.
So children, Everyone refer your workbook page number 30. Okay, and the concept which we are going to learn is conversions of fractions. Clear, children? So 9.2, I recall. First is multiple choice questions. Now look at number 1. What is given here? 4 by 6 plus 1 by 6 equal to how much? So 4 options are given. From here, you have to find out the correct option. Then look at this fraction. Denominators are same. Yes. So what you have to do? Here, we are going to add the numerator. Because denominators are same. So add the numerators. 4 plus 1. It comes how much? 5. So answer will be what? Yes. Is it 2 by 6? No. Is it 4 by 6? No. Is it 5 by 6? Yes. Because when we add numerators, 4 plus 1, we get 5. So answer is what? 5 by 6. Okay, take C and inside the bracket you write C. Number 2, 10 by 11 minus 6 by 11. So here also denominator same. So what we are going to subtract? We are going to subtract the numerators. Okay, again 4 options are given here. From here, we are going to find out the correct option. 10 by 11 minus 6 by 11. So subtract the numerators. 10 minus 6. How much? It is 4. So answer should be 4 by 11. Now let's see the options. A, 4 by 11. B, 16 by 11. C, 0. D, 11 by 11. So which one is the correct answer? Number A. Okay, 10 by 11 minus 6 by 11 equal to 4 by 11. So inside the bracket we will write A. Number 3, 8 by 13 minus 2 by 13. So same, 8 minus 2, 6. So it should be 6 by 13. So let's see the options. A is 5 by 13. No, this is not an answer. B, 7 by 13. This is also not an answer. Number C, 9 by 13. This is also no. Number D, 6 by 13. So 8 minus 2 is 6. So our answer is what? 6 by 13. Yeah. Now come to multiple choice questions. Next multiple choice. Number 4. Numerators of a proper fraction is this its denominator. So in proper fraction, numerators of a proper fraction is this its denominator. See the option. Is it equal to? B, less than. C, greater than. D, all of this. So in proper fraction, numerators are what? It's equal to denominator, greater than denominator, or less than. So in proper fraction, numerators are less than its denominator. So option is B. Okay, so in here we'll write B. Answer is less than. Number 5, if the numerator is equal to the denominator, then the like fraction is dash fraction. If the numerator is equal to the denominator, then the like fraction is this fraction. Is it a mixed fraction, proper fraction, improper fraction, or a like fraction? So if numerator is equal to denominator, then the like fraction is what fraction? We call it an improper fraction. Okay, option is C. Clear? Number 6, the fraction 2, 4 by 9 is this fraction. So what type of fraction this one? Is it a mix, an improper, proper, and unlike? So when a fraction having a whole number and a proper fraction, we call it what? We call it mixed fraction. So answer is A. Okay, answer is what? A, mixed fraction. So fraction 2, 4 by 9 is a mixed fraction. Fill in the blanks. Number 7. Does fractions have their numerators greater than their denominators? In which fractions numerators are greater than their denominators? Children? Yes, what we are going to write here? It is improper fraction. Improper fraction. In improper fraction, numerators greater than their denominators. Okay. Number 8. Mixed fraction have a whole number and a dash fraction. So mixed fractions have what? A whole number and a what fraction? It is proper fraction. So what you are going to write here? Here we are going to write proper fraction. Okay. Now come to number 9. To convert an improper fraction to a mixed fraction, we have to dash the numerator by the denominator. So what we have to do? To convert an improper fraction to a mixed fraction, we have to dash the numerator by the denominator. What we have to do? Conversion of improper fraction to mixed fraction, we have to divide. We have to what? We have to divide. Got it? Now, very short answer questions. Number 10. Convert 12 3 by 5 into its improper fraction. So, what type of fraction this one, children? 12 3 by 5? It's a mixed fraction. Question is asking what? Convert this mixed fraction into its improper fraction. So, how you are going to convert? As I have already explained it to you. Yes, to convert mixed fraction to improper fraction, we have to do what? We are going to multiply whole number into denominator plus numerator by denominator. So 12 into 5, it comes how much? 60 plus 3 by 5. So 63 by 5 is the answer. So when we convert 12 3 by 5 into its improper fraction, you got answer how much? 63 by 5. Then number 11. Convert 14 by 3 to its mixed fraction. Now the reverse one. What you have to do here? This is a what type of fraction? This is an improper fraction. Now this improper fraction, we have to convert it in which fraction? Mixed fraction. So for that, what we have to do? We have to do divide. Yes, so here is less space. So I'll do here, you just see. 14 divided by 3. So 3 4s are 12. So 4 minus 2, 2. So your remainder will be what? Numerator, question will be whole number, and the divisor will be what? Denominator. Yes or no? So answer is what? Answer is, as I have shown you the division, yes, it will be, I'll write here, 4, 2 by 3. So now you see, you check it, whether it is fraction is coming or not. 3, 4 is 12, 12 plus 2, 14, 14 by 3. So when we convert 14 by 3 to its mixed fraction, we get how much? 4, 2 by 3. Yeah. Number 12. Write an example each of a proper and improper fraction. So children, you do it this one as a home practice. Okay, you write it. One example of proper fraction and one example of improper fraction. Now number 13. Convert the mixed fractions into improper fractions. So what you have to do? Here again the conversion of fractions. Mixed fraction to improper fraction. So two are there. I'll show you one and B, you do it. Okay. So 7, 5 by 10. Convert into improper fraction. So what do you have to do? Number A, 7 into 10 plus 5 by 10. 7 into 10, 70 plus 5 by 10. Comes 75 by 10. Got it? Yes. So what we did? Whole number into denominator plus numerator by denominator. 7 into 10, 70 plus 5 by 10. 70 plus 5, 75, 75 by 10 is the answer. Required improper fraction. So B, you do it. Okay? Number 14. Convert the improper fraction into mixed fractions. Now fractions are given an improper fraction. Now you have to convert into mixed fraction. So how you are going to convert? Yes. How you are going to convert improper fraction into mixed fraction? By doing division. So do your division. Number A, 27 divided by 5. 5 into 5, 25. So now 7 minus 5, 2. So the required mixed fraction is what? Remainder will be as numerator. Quotient as whole number. And divisor as denominator. So 5, 2 by 5 is the required mixed fraction. Got it, children? B, you do it. Clear? I've shown you one example. And the next one, the remaining one, you do it. Got it? Question number 15. What is given here? List out proper fraction, improper fraction, and mixed fractions from the following. So certain fractions are given. From here, what you have to do? You have to find out the proper fractions. You have to find out improper fractions and mixed fractions. Okay, separately you have to find out and you have to write. Clear? So children, 15 you do it. Okay, 15 you do it. Question number 16. Children, convert the following into mixed fractions. As I have already shown you and I have already explained it to you how to convert improper fractions into mixed fractions. You all have practiced. So 16 you do it by yourself. Okay. So, 4 are there, A, B, C, D. Kindly, you all complete this. Here, you have to do what? There's improper fractions, you have to convert them into mixed fractions. Question number 17. So, children, till 18, I will do. Yes, in our today's class. So, tomorrow we will continue question number 19 onwards. Okay? So, what is given in question number 17? A basket contains potatoes weighing 3 2 by 3 kg. A basket contains what? Potatoes weight 3 2 by 3 kg and onions weighing 5 2 by 3 kg. Okay, express the weights as improper fraction. So in the basket, potatoes weight and onions weight are given in what? Mixed fractions. So what we have to do? You have to convert that mixed fraction, weight of mixed fraction, as improper fraction. Got it? Yes? So concept is what? Conversion of fraction. So first, what you have to do? Weight of potatoes. Weight of potatoes. Potatoes. How much given? 3 2 by 3. It is given in mixed fraction. So what you have to do? We have to convert them into improper fraction. So for that, what you have to do? Whole number into denominator plus numerator by denominator. So 3 into 3, 9. 9 plus 2. It comes 11 by 3 kg. So weight of potatoes given in mixed fraction, we have converted into what? Improper fraction. So required improper fraction 11 by 3 kg. Weight of potatoes is how much? 11 by 3 kg. Now, next what we have to find out? Weight of onions. Weight of onions. How much given in mixed fraction? 5 2 by 3 kg. So, 5 into 3 plus 2 by 3. So, 5 into 3, 15. 15 plus 2, 17. 17 by 3 kg. So, weight of potatoes, how much we got? 11 by 3 kg. Weight of onions, how much we got? 17 by 3 kg. Got it, children? We have expressed weight as improper fraction. Both potatoes and onions. Question number 18. Next, if the weight of one bag is 13 by 3 kg. So children, what type of fraction is 13 by 3? It is an improper fraction. Yes or no? Because the numerators are greater than denominator. So here numerator is greater than denominator. It's an improper fraction. If the weight of one bag is 13 by 3 kg, then find the weight of two such bags. Give your answer as a mixed fraction. So one bag weight is how much? 13 by 3 kg. Then we have to find out weight. What? We have to find out the weight of two such bags. And after that, we have to give that answer as a mixed fraction. Yes. So, weight of one bag equal to 13 by 3 kg. If one bag weight is 13 by 3 kg, therefore, weight of two bags equal to 13 by 3 plus 13 by 3. Yes, so as the denominator is same, your numerator also same, but we are going to add only the numerator, 13 plus 13 by 3. It comes how much? 26 by 3 kg. Yes. Now, after that, what question ask? Give your answer as a mixed fraction. So now what you have to do? We have to convert this improper fraction into mixed fraction. Yes. So for that, what you have to do? We have to do division. 26 divided by 3. Yes. So 3 into 8. 24. 6 minus 4, 2. So answer is what? 8 quotient will be whole number, divisor will be denominator, remainder will be numerator. So answer is 8 2 by 3 kg. We convert them into as a mixed fraction. Got it, children? So question asked, if the weight of one bag is 13 by 3 kg, then find the weight of two such bags. We got how much? 26 by 3. Yes, after that question asked, give your answer as a mixed fraction. So already we know, when we have to convert improper fraction into mixed fraction, we have to do what? Division. Yes, so after doing division, we got 8 2 by 3 kg. Clear? I hope it is clear to everyone, whatever I have discussed with you, from your workbook, topic conversion of fractions. Yes. So in the next class, we'll continue from question number 19. Okay. And I'll give you now two extra questions. As I've already told you that I'll give you every day two questions. Yes. So you solve it. And in the live class, I'm going to ask you. Clear? So thank you.